Good morning, everybody. Happy Monday. We have an amazing show for everybody today. What do we have, Krystal?
Lots and lots of news to get to. Biden signed a big executive order that Matt Stoller is very excited about with regards to antitrust. We're going to break down what you need to know there. Also going to cover how the media has been covering Afghanistan and what is actually going on the ground there. New indications that in addition to housing prices soaring, rent is now starting to go up through the roof. We've got all of the Hunter Biden news that you crave. Saagar's taking a look at Michael Avenatti. I'm taking a look at the latest developments in Haiti. We've got Jane Costin on from the New York Times to give us a breakdown of what exactly happened at CPAC, what you need to know so you can avoid watching all of the cringe for yourself. But we wanted to start with some new developments with regards to the war on domestic terror.
Yeah, there's been some new additions to the new war on domestic terror and some really troubling stuff when you start to look beneath the surface. So we talked about previously the Capitol Police getting $2 billion in additional funding, and we'll get to their expansion plans in a second. But just to give you an idea of what exactly is being expanded, what exactly is being bought here, let's put this up there on the screen. The Washington Times actually spotted this within a military appropriation. So the Capitol Police will be using an army surveillance system on Americans to, quote, identify an emerging threat. And so this is technology that allowed U.S. troops fighting wars in Afghanistan and Iraq to monitor large areas 24/7 through extremely high resolution cameras. Okay, so these are what we used on bases in Iraq and Afghanistan. Now, people are already discussing about the fact that privacy rights advocates in particular are talking about how the Capitol Police is now deploying extremely high resolution cameras on what large area exactly? Well, we don't really know. Here's the thing. In wartime application, the surveillance units were mounted on tethered blimps. The data would be stored, combined with other data, and then referenced to track individuals or groups across extremely large spaces. Now, the DHS, Department of Homeland Security, has actually used some of this technology here at home, but it's unclear exactly where. Well, now the Pentagon has actually approved a Capitol Police request for 8 of these, what they're called persistent surveillance system ground medium units. It provides high definition surveillance camera and, Krystal, is enabled with night vision. The system, according to the Pentagon, does not have facial recognition capabilities, only this particular system. Whether they are also in possession of such a system, we don't know. And a reasonable person might say, okay, you know, the Capitol, it's that large. It's actually not that big. You really need 8 of these different systems. It's just a very good example of what we discussed around this is not going towards the actual officers, which we're going to get to. This is going towards mass surveillance technology, once again, which we used in Iraq and Afghanistan to track insurgents across the deserts via blimps. That's how crazy things are getting here at home.
Well, we've been to this show before. We have seen the way that police departments were militarized across the country in, you know, bipartisan fashion. And the reason why there's a lot of incentive to push military technology into local police and now Capitol Police is because, number one, there's a lot of contractors who make this stuff, who make a lot of money on it. So there's always this incentive, you definitely need this massive militarized surveillance technology that we can mount on to blimps and make sure we monitor the entire DC area with night vision, et cetera, et cetera. So there's always an incentive to move in this direction, to push this totally unnecessary gear that is also happens to be an infringement on the rights of the people who are being surveilled. You have this push now to turn the Capitol Police, who failed in a Keystone Cops-like manner when it came to January 6th, turn them into like another FBI, basically. That's really what we're seeing here. And we're learning more and more about all of the brand agencies of government that weirdly have like these surveillance and investigatory powers that we never knew that they had. So you have way more money going to the Capitol Police. You have an agency that dramatically failed on January 6th are being rewarded with more money, more power, more equipment so that they can, I guess, fail on an even larger scale next time around and seize even more power for themselves. This is how the cycle works over and over again. Y'all didn't need any surveillance technology. None of us needed any of this to know that there was a risk on January 6th. People were talking about it. it out in the open. Maybe if you'd been able to, like, get your riot shields and have enough people on the ground, none of this would have happened. So the idea that we need new laws, new equipment, new surveillance powers, any of that is just silly. If they had just been prepared and actually done the job on that day, which, by the way, isn't about the individual officers, many of whom performed very bravely.
Right.
This is about leadership and planning and taking seriously, not even the intelligence, the literal out in the open discussion of what they wanted to do on this day.
And the Big Brother vibes continue to get really creepy. I mean, the FBI actually tweeted this out yesterday. Let's put this up there on the screen. Family members and peers are often best positioned to witness signs of mobilization to violence. Help prevent homegrown violent extremism. Visit gousa.gov to learn how to spot suspicious behaviors and report them to the FBI. Hashtag NatSec. I mean, this is straight Big Brother, like, Stasi level stuff. They're encouraging people to spy on their family and report them. And I still remember there was a great moment during the Joe Rogan episode when we were on, and Joe was like, wait, what does domestic extremism mean? And I was like, well, that's the 15, 20, 50, billion-dollar question there, isn't it, Joe? Because what does homegrown violent extremism mean? What does it mean for you to report on your family to the FBI? Does it mean liking a tweet, making fun of people? Oh, wait, that's actually already happened. The Capitol Police has dispatched sheriff deputies to that left-wing podcaster's home who liked a tweet which was critical of AOC. This is where this type of stuff leads to. And even more, if you want to see how much these people are reaching, let's put this up there, which is that the FBI, you know, the DOJ, in their indictment against one of these Capitol rioters, cited as evidence of planning that he had, and they put this seriously, this is not a joke, that he had a, quote, fully constructed Capitol Lego model, as in the Lego Capitol set, which, by the way, I have. It's in a box. I haven't actually fully constructed it, but I mean, that is the level of insanity that we're getting to here, Krystal, which is that they are citing Legos as evidence of planning. Look, the guy was probably a moron. He stormed on in there with a bunch of other morons, and you know what? He's gonna pay the price and he's gonna go to jail. It's like, to build your case against him, take the little photo of him inside the Capitol and be like, hey, you broke the law, dude. Sorry. Instead, they had to go through all these machinations and they went through his notebook.
It's like so nefarious that he had a Lego set.
Yeah, the Lego set right over there. It's like, what is going on here? And I mean, I shouldn't be laughing. This is serious stuff. Like, they're going to go into your house and they're going to say, like, oh, he's got the Legos in the corner. It means he's a domestic violent extremist. I don't even know how they continue to beclown themselves in the way, except for the fact that they are getting away with this. The media is fully behind them. The Biden administration is full-blown against this whole new war on domestic terror. And the further it goes, really, the scarier it all is. And like I said, the $2 billion appropriation that was given to the Capitol Police, it is gone now to expanding their offices and more, but they don't even have the money to pay their own cops, the actual cops in the building. Just the other day, let's put this up there, after the appropriation passed, Senator Patrick Leahy has to ask the Senate to pass an additional $30 million in overtime for the Capitol Police. And I saw a big thread from Capitol Hill reporter Jake Sherman about how the Capitol Police is supposedly on the verge of bankruptcy after we just gave them $2 billion. So what are they doing? They're buying these blimp, you know, surveillance tech, and they're not even spending it on the actual beat cops in the building. It's on expanded offices. Just a reminder, in California and in Florida, that's what we showed you guys in our last show, they're planning field offices all across the country outside of Washington to, quote, track threats to lawmakers. It's just completely dystopian.
So in that FBI tweet where they're asking you to, like, spy on your family members, I looked up some of what the suspicious indicators are that they want you to look for. And some of them are genuinely concerning, like illegally acquiring weapons and things like that.
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that's a crime in and of itself. But then there are also things like purchasing tactical equipment.
Okay.
You're allowed to do that.
Yes, it's free country.
Free country. You're allowed to purchase tactical equipment. You also have suspicious financial transactions.
What does that mean?
I don't know what
that
means.
So they want you to go into your like partner's Venmo history
and be like, unusual applications for increases of credit guys, also in America, a lot of people have a lot of credit card debt.
Yeah, but you want to, I was like,
that
exactly.
is a scourge of America, like, but it's hardly an indicator of extremist activity.
Okay.
Disposing of personal assets or belongings in an unusual manner. Don't know what that means exactly. Unusual goodbyes.
So check your trash. Okay, got
so,
it.
So, I mean, it's just, it shows you, like, I think if you have this frame in your mind of you're looking for this everywhere, then you can see it everywhere, right? It's like once you adopt that frame of like, well, why did he make that purchase? Mm-hmm. Well, why did they take out this credit line? Well, why did they say goodbye to me in that way? You can just see how this becomes incredibly invasive, especially when you have what makes it so is that you have a media that for years now has been so invested in convincing people that everyone around them who doesn't agree with them politically is not just like a good faith person who happens to view the world a little differently, but is an active threat. And so when you couple a media and political climate that relentlessly convinces you that it's a sectarian nation, that people are extremists on both sides who don't just have political disagreements with you, but are actively either violent or want to destroy your way of life. And then you put in a government agency out there saying, and no, you know what, you should be reporting these people. You should be paying attention. You should be sending them into the authorities, letting us know about these people. That's where this ends up being incredibly dystopian and frankly disturbing. And that's the climate that's being created here. That's the climate that gets, you know, amplified when you have the Capitol Police now being empowered as basically like another FBI, being militarized in a way that we've seen was incredibly troubling and not ultimately serving the interest of community peace when those police units across the country were militarized. And we just keep seeing signs that we're moving more and more and more in this direction, which is why we cover this, because this goes to the core of what is the culture and what is the climate in this country? Are we going to be able to move together forward as like one unified nation? And all of these little things just serve to harden and heighten those sectarian divisions that make it very impossible, you know, nearly impossible for a democratic society to survive.
I think that's really, really well said.
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching.
That's right. Just as a reminder, you can become a premium subscriber today. Watch the full show completely uncut. Our reactions to each other's monologues. You get to listen to it. You get to ask us questions. All that good stuff. Link is right there in the description or at breakingpoints.com.
Best of all, great way to say screw you to the mainstream media.